So, had me a conversation the other Friday night with my boys of the Non Sequitur show. Yeah, I still like those guys. They're cool guys. They're good guys. They're becoming like family, or at least they are to me. And this guy, Nate, talks to you from some very popular YouTube channel. So we're having a conversation about personal destiny. And I was trying to lay a case in the course of the debate. I was trying to lay a case for the Christian worldview as to what constitutes a personal destiny, why you were put on this earth, and what might be your God's goal for your life. And to be quite frank, I didn't do a very good job of it. It turned into more of a debate, and I was trying to make these points that I never really fully brought out. So I'll elaborate now. Now, one of the things I was trying to point out, and this is totally consistent with Christian theology, and this is something I started to believe long before I became a Christian. That was why it was a lot easier for me to actually become a Christian, because this was something that I believed deeply prior to me becoming a believer in God, in Christ. Each and every one of us, and this is Christian theology, is born with a personal destiny in mind. The etymology of the word is totally related to destination, and end product, a result, a go-to place, something you were specifically fashioned in God's heart and mind before he laid the foundation of the world to accomplish in this lifetime with gifts that are specific to you personally. And you are supposed to take those gifts and you are supposed to produce something great with your life for the glory of God. That's actual Christian theology. Before I laid the foundation of the universe, I knew you and I called you by name for such a time as this as you were created, etc., etc. I can back it up with scriptures morning, noon, and night. Now, we started talking about, let's say, for example, argument's sake, Keith Richards. Keith Richards, in my estimation, is an excellent guitarist. First off, what do we learn? Well, let's assume for argument's sake that I'm telling you the truth. So Keith Richards was specifically designed to be a guitarist and give glory to God through music. Now, the Bible also says the gifts of God are without repentance. So those gifts were given to Keith Richards, and he's free to do with them as he will. I don't know if you listen to the Rolling Stones, but it's not exactly the most Christian of rock outfits, as good as they are. You know, they even sing songs here and there about the devil. Yeah, it's shocking. Shocking. I was shocked when I heard it. So Keith Richards, he was designed specifically with a purpose in mind when God laid the foundation of the universe. Let's take somewhere where it's a bit more pure and a bit more obvious, that like Beethoven is the one that is my fallback position. If I'm telling the truth and I'm correct, and Beethoven was designed to specifically give glory to God through music, to specifically do what he did, bring beautiful sympathies. And if you have any doubts, go listen to Ninth Symphony, Second Movement. Best piece of music out there. And go listen to Gimme Shelter for opening bars. Also the best piece of music out there. Two best pieces of music. Go listen to both of them if you have doubts about those two choices. Specifically designed to give glory to God through music, designed with that purpose in mind. To disrespect that, to violate that, to not bring that to fruition. It's the first time you'll ever hear me use the word sin. That would be an incalculable moral sin. Why? Because not only are you robbing yourself of the goodness and glory that God put inside of you, but you are potentially robbing the entire world. The entire world. Of the thing that you specifically were purposed to do. Imagine Martin Luther King if he had not fulfilled his personal destiny. Imagine what an impoverished world we would live in today. Imagine Beethoven if he had not fulfilled his personal destiny. He decided to walk away. Now, if you are an atheist, as far as I'm concerned, this is inarguable. You can argue with it just to make noise, but this is not negotiable. This is an actual dichotomy. There is no such thing as a personal destiny, an intrinsic personal destiny. If there is no God that created us, then in real philosophical terms, it makes absolutely no difference if you fashion yourself to become X or you become Y. It doesn't make any difference whatsoever. You can fashion your life according to your personal preference, because there was nothing specifically you were put here to do with your time on earth. Now that's fairly obvious, and that's a no-brainer. Axiomatic. I tried to point that out in the debate, I believe. Didn't really go that well. Wasn't my great winning debate. It was, you know, whatever, C plus. But if you were specifically designed with a purpose in mind, with God's purpose put inside of you, so that you could bring something beautiful and great to fruition in this lifetime, and you walk away from that, that's a crime. That's a crime. So why do people do it? Well, let's take a look at Ron Jeremy, the other example I brought up. And that didn't go over too well in the debate either. Honestly didn't. It kind of threw everything up into cuckoo land. Now, there is no such thing as somebody who is fashioned in God's mind to be a porn star before he laid the foundation of the world. As much fun as we had, you know, laughing about the idea, it's just not so. So why do people have things written inside of them and then betray their very own potential soul, betray the very foundation of who they are, and walk away and do something else with their life? Pollute their talents like that, disrespect themselves like that. Why? The case of porn star is pretty obvious. I don't know if you've ever been to a strip club, if you've ever talked to strippers. If you haven't, I promise you, I have. 99 times out of 100, and this is no exaggeration, you can go to a strip club tomorrow and find out I'm telling you the truth. 99 times out of 100, there's wounding there that is deep and it is dark. There is some sort of sick relationship with the father, usually, and 99 times out of 100, there is sexual abuse somewhere in their background. A trusted uncle, somebody grabbed them the wrong way sometime when they were really, really young and hurt them. And they carried that pain around with them for the rest of their life. Distorting their relationship, distorting forever their relationship with potentially who they were designed to be. I promise you that's true. I promise you, go to a strip club tomorrow. Ask all the girls there. You'll find out. The first thing you'll find out is all of them have daddy issues that are really, really intense. And 75% of them will tell you stories of sexual trauma before the age of 9 or 10. I promise you it's true. Go to pornography. Go watch the people who are involved in pornography. Same thing. You listen to the stories long enough, it'll tear your heart out. So what happens? People get traumatized. Evil things come against them when they are trying to become who they are in this world. And it distorts their relationship, not only to the society at large, but to themselves. More importantly, it distorts their relationship to themselves. You could try to tell somebody who's been wounded by sexual trauma that God loves them and they got something beautiful inside them and God wants them to bring it to fruition. Good luck with it. You can try to tell it to someone, they aren't going to hear. Why? Because they believe something really, really deep and dark differently. And hidden places that you will never be able to access. And it clouds their relationship with themselves from the point of wounding to the rest of their life. Rest of their life. Promise you this is true. I promise you this is true. What I'm saying isn't all that radically hard to understand. If you even have a casual relationship, you know, I've known a bunch of strippers in my days and I have long conversations about this with them. And I'm telling you the God's honest truth, and almost any stripper you get to listen to this will tell you, yeah, that's true. Yeah, that's God's honest truth. It's hard for somebody to believe who has been hurt deeply at innocent ages. It's hard for somebody to believe that they were designed for a purpose, that they might be something great. It's hard. So, that's just one aspect of it, and I'll go more into another video. This is a subject that I will bring up time and time again, because this is a subject that is near and dear to my heart. So, amen for now. Bye-bye.